Welcome to the Good News Podcast with Randy Ajema. We believe you'll be transformed and be blessed as you listen. And now, let's get into today's message.
When you read Hebrews chapter 13, verse number 5, the NIV version says that, keep your lives free from the love of money and be content with what you have. Because God has said, never will I leave you, never will I forsake you. You see, as a born-again child of God, you have to understand that God wants your life to be void of covetousness. In other words, God doesn't want you to lust after what belongs to others. He wants you to be content with what you have. Nyamin person ebe bia enibe bradi. Ene nyamin person ebe bia benye suban a neni bradi amanfo ere ewo. Tina babo ne se yema yeni so ni ayede yewo. You need to learn to be content with what God has given to you. Adwuma na nyame dia ma wo no eno na nyame dia ma wo at this level ma woni nso bere ma nyame dina ma wo aware no ono na nyame dina ma wo ma woni nso e ma wo wo no eno na nyame dia ma wo ma woni nso. The job you have, the marriage you have, that is what God has given to you. So the Bible says, be content with what you have. Don't wish, say, I wish so and so was my husband. I wish I was married to so and so. I wish I had this company. I wish I was working in this company. I wish I was affiliated or associated with this person. God says every child of God should be content with what they have. The gift God has given to you in ministry, be content with it. Don't lust after what someone has. God wants our lives to be void of covetousness. Now, that doesn't mean you shouldn't dream or desire to attain greater levels of success. Rather, it emphasizes being fulfilled and understanding that what you have is enough to get whatever else you want. But you have to also understand that the truth is, there is nothing actually that you need in life anymore. Why am I saying that? Because 1 Corinthians chapter 3 verse 21 says, all things are yours. The child of God has everything in the world belongs to you. This is better than anything. The Bible also says that Christ in you, the hope of glory. So in Him, you have all things. If you remember the crippled man, the beggar at the gate of the temple called Beautiful, when he asked Peter and John for alms, when he asked them for money, Peter didn't say, well, I don't have what you're asking me or what you're asking for, and then just walked away. Peter knew he had something, and what he had was enough to produce whatever else may be required. He used what he had, that is the name of Jesus, in the power of the Holy Spirit, to effect a cure and restore life to the man's dead and crippled limbs. Peter and Kase made him initiate. Christo ni bia na ojidi ni bia nyame be bia nyame hom ti hom nyame hom ne rade di ebade nyina. And God said, let there be light. That means say your father is a creator, you too, you are a creator. Whatever you don't have, you can create it, because he has given you the power to use the name of Jesus to effect change. It is all about becoming aware, being conscious of what you have, the power and glory of Christ in your spirit. Your heart is the habitation of the Lord. Do you know what that means? That means the ability of God is operational in you. So how could anyone know this and ever be in lack or in need or be envious of others? That is why this knowledge is coming to you now. So you will be content and confident in who you are, what you have, and all that Christ is to you and in you and has wrought in your spirit. Never think if only you had this or that. You have the most important thing, that is Christ. That's all you need. Christ in you is the hope of glory, the guarantee that everything else you could ever require is already in you. Christ in you is the reason everything else you need is certain. Because say yes, the Bible say onyankopon wamfa ndoba ba kwan kamia adentina wamfa die nyina so enka na homedom ye. If God did not deny us of his only begotten son, how much more will he deny us of everything else? No. Say nyame de ndoba ba kopɛ ema wo. What is that car that you're asking for? What is that money? What is that employment that you're looking for that God cannot give you? I and tell so when you break will be said, ah, we say will be a juma we, we say will be so worry, we say will be so na brabo kweni munami dear. No, it's all about what you have on the inside. Become aware of what you carry. Christ in you is the hope of glory. That means oh, we need a soul. Glory is in you. That means your God is going to glorify you in the end. Because Christ is in you. God will bring it to pass because Christ is inside you. God bless you.
God bless you for listening to this message. Make sure you subscribe to Randy Ajema's YouTube channel for more audio and video messages every week, including his unlimited dynamic worship songs. And remember, your life will never be the same.